I'm gonna go ahead and finish up the suturing. And how are you feeling?
A standardized patient, by definition, is a healthy person from the community that we bring in and we teach them to be sick.
And this is Drew. The person who role plays actually being a patient presenting with symptoms, conditions, couldn't talk at all.
Couldn't talk at all at first.
I've got people who not only can facilitate learning, they're very bright, they can memorize checklists, and they have a dedication to students' learning.
Ooh. Good, yeah.
Excellent.
It's the common goal of, but I want to help.
Because I want to help medical students understand how to communicate effectively with people. One of your areas you could strengthen would be the area of empathy.
Right now we have 113 standardized patients.
Move around their thumb.
Working with our students from the first year of medical school.
I'll be sitting in the chair and a student will not come in and start interviewing, finding out what the problem is. Of course, it's in a time situation.
Do you have any questions? Did I cover everything?
And they would see a standardized patient. They would be videotaped. Watch it. What were you thinking? Why did you say it? So they dissected the encounter.
Additionally, the standardized patient is able to give constructive feedback.
Excellent eye contact.
We're always trying to think, how can we alleviate some of the teaching that our faculty are required to do, especially the basic skills? I'm not talking about clinical reasoning. We're talking about the very basic skills.
Your last one was actually nicely spaced around the wound itself.
We thought, okay, a couple of those skills would be suturing. It's because there is a checklist.
Just keep dividing the wound.
We can make sure that all of our students learn the same technique.
As soon as you pierce it, I want you to turn your wrist. Yeah, that's good.
That good?
So when they go out to work with the faculty, now the faculty can start talking a little more about clinical and then how to do some of those shortcuts.
No, but that was really helpful.
Our students are comfortable in talking to patients.
When you put the knot off to the side, does every knot have to be on that side? Does it matter?
But while they're doing that, they're also out in the community working with real patients. And so they come here, learn it, practice it, learn it, practice it, learn it, practice it. And I think that is what's become such a strength of our curriculum and our graduates. We do have resident directors who call and say, you know, do you have any residents that are coming my way? We'd really like to see them, because they know that they're going to hit the ground running.